हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हैप्पी मॉर्निंग। क्लास 12 फिजिक्स यूनिट 6 रे ऑप्टिक्स कंटिन्यूएशन वीडियो। इन टुडेज क्लास लेट वी सी द फिजियो मेथड टू डिटरमाइन द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट। फिजियो इज़ अ वन दैट कैन गिव एन एक्सपेरिमेंट टू फाइंड द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट। वी नो वेरी वेल लाइट ट्रैवल विद द मैक्सिमम स्पीड दैट इज 3×10⁸ मीटर पर सेकेंड। हियर फिजियो इज़ अ फ्रेंच साइंटिस्ट हू गेव एन एक्सपेरिमेंट to find the speed of light. Okay, let we see the apparatus of the experiment. The apparatus of the experiments are, first one is light source, that is indicated as S. Okay, then the second one is partially silvered glass plate. That is G. Okay. Then rotating tooth devil. Rotating tooth devil. Having N cuts and N teeth. Okay. Here the rotating speed is adjusted by some external mechanism. This is not discussed here. Okay. Here the apparatus consists of a source. From that source there will be a light ray. Okay. It made to fall on a partially silvered glass plate. Partially silvered glass plate. Okay. Okay, this is that glass plate. This is G, that is inclined at an angle 45 degree with the instant light. Okay, then it will reflect. At this path there will be a tooth reveal. There will be a tooth reveal having N cuts and N tooth. Okay. Here the light pass through the cut, not through the teeth. Okay, the teeth block the light and the cut can enter the light. Okay, that allow the light. From 8 km from the rotating tooth reveal, there will be a mirror. The mirror will reflect the light and again it pass through the same cut. Okay, at that first instant, the angular velocity of the tooth reveal will be zero. That means it is not rotating. Okay. At that instant, the light from the mirror will pass through the same cut, whatever it enters. Okay. It pass through the same cut. Then next, I am increasing the angular velocity omega from zero to omega. At a particular value of omega, the reflected light from the mirror is blocked by the adjacent cut. Okay, sorry, adjacent slot or adjacent teeth. Okay, here I am increasing the angular speed from 0 to omega. At that instant, the reflected light from the mirror M is blocked by the adjacent tooth. Okay, this is not observed here by the observer. Initially, the rotating that is the tooth reveal not rotating. At that instant we can receive the reflected light from the same cut. Then I am rotating the tooth reveal with an angular velocity omega. At that instant the reflected light is blocked by the adjacent tooth of that slot. Okay, here we know it travel a distance 2d, that is equal to 8 km at a time t. Then let we see the expression for the speed of light. We know velocity v is equal to 2d by t, because that is d, it come in the same direction, that is 2d. Okay, then we need t, so omega is equal to theta by t. Here omega is the angular speed of the tooth reveal. Okay. Then theta, that is an angle between tooth and the cut, next cut or slot. Okay. See. Center of the teeth to the center of the slot. This is theta. Okay. Then we can write theta as theta is equal to total angle of the circle to the total angle of the circle in radian to the number of teeth plus number of cuts. Okay. That is 2 pi. We know here it is 2n. Okay, then solving this we get pi by n. We know theta is equal to pi by n. Then we can write omega. Omega is equal to theta by t. Then omega is equal to theta became pi by nt. Okay, we need the value of t alone. Then t is equal to pi by n omega. Okay. Substitute in velocity, Vd is equal to 2d by t, then 2d by pi n omega. Okay, by substituting this value, that V is approximately equal to 3 into 10 power of 8 meter per second. Okay, this is not solved by physio. Okay, some other scientist with a sophisticated experiment, he found that velocity V is equal to 2.99792 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Okay, then let we see the speed of light through vacuum and different media. Okay, after physio there will be two scientists, that is named as Flockhart and Michelson. He found that the velocity of the light in medium other than the vacuum is less. Okay, comparing with the velocity of light in the medium with the vacuum, that will be less. Okay, so they are introduced the glass, water or some other transparent medium in the path of the light in the same experiment. Okay, he found that velocity of light in the medium is always less than velocity of light in vacuum. Okay. And also they found that in between the sawtooth reveal and the mirror, they are placing the discharge tube. Okay. In that discharge tube, there is nothing is there, only vacuum. They found that in vacuum, velocity of light will be V is equal to C, that is equal to 3 into 10 power of 8 meter per second. Okay, the next refractive index. It is represented by the symbol N. Okay, refractive index means how much times the velocity of light decreases in that medium with respect to the vacuum. Okay. Refractive index of the transparent medium, it is defined as, it is a ratio of speed of the light in vacuum to the speed of the light in medium. Vacuum to the speed of light in medium. That is C by V. So there is no unit for a refractive index. Okay. The small value of refractive index is only for vacuum. Okay. Small value of refractive index is for vacuum, that is n is equal to 1 for vacuum. Okay, for other medium, for other mediums always n is greater than 1. Okay, see, refractive index increases with velocity decreases. Okay, that means if I consider a medium having the refractive index n that is greater than 1, here it is a vacuum, here it is a medium. Okay, here light travels with the velocity c, that is 3 × 10⁻ m/s, 3 × 10⁸ m/s, but for the medium it travels with less velocity. Okay, it will reduce by this much times, that is known as refractive index. Refractive index is a factor that which how much times the velocity of light decreases in that medium. Okay, the next one, that is optical path. Optical path of a medium, it is defined as a distance d dash the light travel in vacuum, in the same time it travel a distance d in the medium. Okay, here first of all I consider a medium, okay, having refractive index n. Here it is a medium having the refractive index n, and the thickness of that medium will be d. Okay, here we know light travels with the speed v in the medium. Okay, but for the vacuum it travels with the velocity c. See, first of all the light travel a distance d with the velocity v in this medium at a time interval t. Okay, here light travel with a speed v in a time t. Okay, here it is a medium. At the same time, okay, v can be written as distance by time, then t is equal to t by v. At the same time the light travel a distance d dash in vacuum. Okay, here it is vacuum. Okay, it travel d dash with the velocity c at the same time t. So we can write c is equal to d dash by t, then t is equal to d dash by c. Okay, these two times are same, so we can equate these two, then we get d dash by c is equal to d by v. Okay, then d dash is equal to c by v into d. Here c by v is nothing but it is a ratio of velocity of light in vacuum to the velocity of light in medium. Then we can write d dash is equal to nd. Here d dash is nothing but the optical path. Okay, optical path of a medium, that is defined as a distance d dash the light travel in vacuum, in the same time it travel a distance d in the medium. Okay, see, optical path d dash, okay, this is defined as a light travel in vacuum, at the same time t it travel a distance d in the medium. Okay, this is known as optical path. Okay, listen, for other mediums we know, for other mediums n is greater than 1. Okay, so we can consider d dash is always greater than d. Optical path is always greater than d. D dash is a distance traveled in vacuum, d is a distance traveled in medium. Always light travel larger distance in vacuum compared with the medium at the same time. Okay, this is known as optical path.